In this video, we'll try to understand how we can test private methods using Visual Studio Unit Test. But before I move with the video ahead, let me admit, or I'll say let me make a confession, I'm a strong opponent of unit testing private methods. For me, or must be, you know, for a lot of people, unit testing means the class as a whole. So if you test the public methods of the class, the private methods get tested as well. You know, it is like saying that, you know, should we test the wall or should we test the individual bricks of the wall? So logically, if the wall stands the test, then the bricks are all doing well. But, you know, if you ask me personally, you know, sometimes I think, okay, that there is nothing called as probably standard or best practice. Probably they are just popular opinions. So this must be one of the popular opinions, you know, saying that you should only test the public method and the private methods get tested automatically. There is other school of thought who think that unit can be lines of code, it can be methods, it can be private methods also. So they think that if you are testing private methods, it's okay and ethically right. So many times, you know, you come across weird situations, like you are trying to zero on the method where the defect is. So in those kind of scenarios, you know, testing private methods is probably a reasonable solution. So in simple words, you know, both of these schools are right probably. It's only that thought, you know, saying that what is a unit. So if you think that unit is a class, then probably you should be only testing public methods. But if you think no, that unit, you know, can be some lines of code, it can be some method, you know, then probably, you know, testing private methods are okay. So what is the definition of unit? You know, that varies from person to person and developer to developer. So with due respect, you know, to people who think that testing private methods are right and appropriate, so in this video, we'll see that how we can test private methods in a proper and easy manner. So you can see that I have a very simple class here called as a maths class, and this maths class has a very simple function here called as an add function. Now, you know, to this add function, you cannot pass numbers which are negative. So what I've done is, you know, for that, I have created a very simple private function here called as isNegative. So whenever you pass numbers here, the first thing what it does is it actually goes and checks if the number is negative or not. If the number is negative, then it does not allow you to move ahead. So let's say now we would like to go and test this isNegative private method here. Okay. Now, you know, if you want to invoke this private method, one of the ways in .NET is by using reflection. So by using reflection, you can actually go and browse through the members of the class, and then you can say that, okay, here's the isNegative method and you can invoke it. Okay. But the good news is that you don't need to write any kind of reflection code when it comes to VSTS unit test. In VSTS unit test, we have a very nice class here called as the private object class. This private object class will take care of all the reflection at the backend. So what you can do here is, in order to invoke this isNegative function here, you can say private object. So create object of this private object class, new private object. And we need to pass the type of this class. So the type of this class means this maths type, you know, to the private object constructor. So we have to say here type of maths. And now we can use the invoke method of the private object. So we can say here bool result is equal to obj dot invoke. So which private method you want to invoke? I want to invoke the private method is negative. So we'll say, okay, invoke is negative. And let's pass the value -1. So we are actually passing -1 here. So this is negative. So this should actually return true, right? So we'll say here assert dot r equal. We expect this to be true because we are passing a negative value. And we'll check this value against the result, right? Okay. So now I'll go and run this test case, this unit test case. So right click, let's go and debug it. So I'm going to go and right click and say debug selection. So we can actually see this is negative private method actually getting invoked. Okay. So there it is, there it goes. So F11, now you can see the private method is getting invoked. So internally, the private object class is using reflection to invoke this is negative method. So you can see I'm passing here -1. So -1 is actually less than 0, so it returns true. So in other words, you know, this test negative, this thing is working. So it will actually say that yes, that you pass negative and he's actually giving you out true, right? So in other words, you know, if you want to go and invoke a private method in a unit test, in VSTS unit test, you can use this private object class. Now, as I've said, you know, when we started this video, that I'm a very strong opponent of testing private methods. When you are testing private methods, you know, that means, you know, there is something wrong in the class design. For example, in this case, you know, you can see that this maths class is actually violating SRP, that is single responsibility principle. What is single responsibility principle? Single responsibility principle says that one class should do only one thing. It should not, you know, get loaded with a lot of responsibilities. For example, when we say that this is a maths class, then what it should do is it should only do arithmetic operations like add, subtract, multiply. But what it is doing now is it is also doing numeric checks. It is also doing validations. So probably it would be a good idea, you know, if we move this is negative from here to probably to a different class called as validator, must be, right? And this validator object we create inside this add method. So we make this is negative as public, and we create the object of validator here, okay? And then we use this validator object, you know, to check the validations. So dot is negative, right? So, you know, whenever you are testing private methods, you know, that means, you know, there is something wrong in the class design, or else testing private methods, you know, does not mean anything. You test the public methods, and the public methods will actually invoke the private methods, and the testing will happen as a single unit. So in case, you know, if you are testing private methods, that means probably there is a violation of single responsibility principle. Probably that class is getting overloaded with a lot of responsibility, and it is time to do refactoring and move that code into a separate class, so that, you know, this class is having only single responsibility. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand how we can invoke private methods, you know, when we do VSTS unit test. Thank you so much.